Because he had like a legit way to kill myself even if I taunt something out.
Watch your back.
I must protect.
Okay. If this is like Cancer Rogue, I might as well just keep swipe, but at the same time, not really. So Harvest Golem is really good versus, not really good, but is decent versus Miracle Rogues. Oh my god, Yeti, please, top deck Yeti, please. Oh, not really. Yeah, I'm gonna innervate a Harvest Golem here, because next turn I can coin a Harvest Golem. And if this is the aggro version of the rogue, I'm in like a really good spot. And if it's Miracle, I'm in a good spot too. I just need to get card draw or like not useless creatures. Oh wow. Interesting. I think I'll go Wildgrove. It's another Harvest Golem would put a lot of pressure on him, but Wildgrove basically let me play a 4 drop or even a 5 drop next turn since I have the coin. And playing a 5 drop, what the fuck was that? Okay. Should I kill that though? He went like Naked SA Agent, which means he wants to trade like this. I might as well just go another Harvest Golem. I can always Hero Power next turn. Or I could coin Hero Power. Actually. I'm gonna coin Hero Power. Just because Farseer is really popular. So he might trade and Farseer the SK, this SI agent, and I'm in a world of trouble. This board is like only vulnerable to backstab Hank of Knives. But he had like no backstab because he would combo the SK, this SI agent last turn. And if he Hank of Knives and Deadly Poison, it's okay I guess. It's really good for him, but I can't do much about it, so it's probably Hank of Knives. Yeah, but it's decent, I guess. It's not really decent, he's in a really good spot, to be honest. I have no draw, so since I have 2 big game hunters, I'm gonna play it anyway. If he's gonna go to make a big Van Cleef, I'm gonna big game hunter, so it's fine. But yeah, he's like in a really good spot. I had a really good start, but Miracle Rogue is, if he has the answer to it, Miracle Rogue is really good at clearing your board. Because he has a backstab, SI agent, deadly poison, which are really really cheap and deal like 2 damage, which most creatures have that life. Oh, that Yeti is really good though. This will probably get eviscerated, but like Shiva eviscerated, but it's fine. I'm not gonna play Agent Watcher, there's no need to do that. If he has like a Gadget Zone prep eviscerate, the game is pretty much GG. And the conceal, then it's GG. If you get the right cards, I should say, with this deck, it's a 50-50 against Miracle. Just because you have big guys, but it's not like an Ancient of War. Imagine that he has to go through 10 HP points without... if he doesn't have a sap, so he will waste a lot of burst and damage on a creature, and he will not have enough damage to kill you. I'm not that worried about the big Van Cleef right now because he's not having that many cards, So I'm just gonna be Game Hunter again, just to put some pressure or just to trade like this. I could also just go Ancient Watcher. I think I should have played the Ancient Watcher last turn. Just because I might go Rag. I will most likely go Rag next turn, so... Oh, damn. Now, this Rag has to kill the Auctioneer, pretty much. Oh, never mind, I'll probably Force of Nature if he calls plus this. I'm gonna Force of Nature here. Right, Force of Nature. Oh my god, I'm so low. Oh wow. Oh damn, now I have to Rag here, I guess. Yeah, but if he has Sap... So, if I'm gonna go Rag, he basically... This is so hard. I wonder. He has like two threats on board, which I can't kill either because I have no fucking graph. But if I go Force of Nature, basically I can kill this. I can kill anything, both creatures, but I'll take another 6 damage. I mean 7 damage, which is... And I'll die to Eviscerate or something. So I think I'll just have to Rag here to go for the win. I don't even... The game is pretty much over, so... I don't even know. Because if I kill this, yes, I will mitigate some damage, but... He will have the gadgets in and draw the whole deck. Druid of the Claw in Taunt mode is not an option, to be honest. So I guess I'd just go Force of Nature. Game is pretty much over. I have like the worst hand in the world. Yeah, but the game is over. He got me good. There's no way I'm gonna survive with this much HP. But at the same time, the other plays were as bad as the Force of Nature one. Wow, I'm actually not dead. What? No, or Shiv, Eviscerate Shiv. Wait, no combo on Eviscerate. What? What the fuck is going on? He fucked that up. What? Where shall I strike? What was that? Seriously? He missed little, I mean. I'm probably still dead because... Yeah, but... What the fuck was that? He eviscerated before Blade Fury. He top deck. I was actually not going to die if he didn't get Sinister Strike. That was like such a bad play from him. Because if I get an Ancient of Lore, I'm gonna heal myself and with the town down, I'm not gonna die from straight up burst. He had 3 cards in his hand, no way to kill him. To kill me, and I have the taunt down, so no way he would Lero into that. Oh my god, that was such a bad play from him, but somehow he top decked the Sinister Strike. Yeah, so this is probably Zhu, so I'm just gonna mulligan to face Zhu. Wildgrowth, it's a bit slow versus Zhu, but it's really good. I'm just gonna go and go Wildgrowth, I don't care. I might lose the game for this, but... Oh my god. The Double Swiperino, what? What? If this is Zhu... OMG Jesus. Is there any reason to go... Coin Wildgrowth? Yeah, because I have Harvest Golem. Basically, you shouldn't go Coin Wildgrowth unless you have a 3 drop play. And this is Handlock. Oh my god. I'm actually in a decent spot. If I get my Big Game Hunters as fast as possible. Oh my god, the Keeper of Grove. He will tap this turn and probably play a Giant next turn that will die to the Silence. So I'm really happy about it, and I got the big game hunter. This is like more than GG. Well, not really GG. The game can go either way, but yeah. I should be really careful about playing Khan Breath of just because of Faceless. If he Faceless this, then it's pretty bad for me. There goes the giant, and there goes the BGH. I'm sorry, bruh. Should I Ancient Watcher here? Probably not. Just because of Hellfire and stuff like that. Although Hellfire is not really viable here. But I have like so much burst. If I can keep the swipe. Drain life. What? 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 What in the butt? I think I'm gonna Karn it, even if he has like a Faceless, it's not that bad because I have a Silence, so I'm just gonna go YOLO Karn. Even though Faceless, probably Henlock plays one, like, you can have like no Faceless and have Sylvanas and I don't even know. What's that card name? The... Alexstrasza and not having any Faceless, so he got both giants really quick. I mean, but at the same time I killed one with the BG8, so I guess it's fair. What can I do? I can swipe this. Kill this. Kill this. Yeah, just kill this and go Ancient Witcher. I almost wanted to mark up the wildest just because it won't die to Mortal Coil, but this guy just played the drain life, so I guess anything is possible. I won. Game looks fine. I should be able to win this. I have an answer for a Keeper of the Grove. He played both giants. I have burst to get through the through his life. So if he's not gonna clear anything, actually it's really hard for him to clear anything. Yeah, that's the right play. Oh my god, that top deck. That was basically the best card I could get, right there. I just because if I get like Ragnaros or something, I can't just play it because he will be like at 10 health and he would be able to play double Molten Giants for free. Keeping him at above like 16 at this point in the game, or like 15, it's really good because he will not be able to play both Giants. He'll have to play one at a time so I can deal with it. I also have a big game hunter in this deck, so there's no rush for me to win. Sunfury? Oh my god, I just won, right? Because 6, 9, 11. I'm one short little, what the fuck? I'm one short little. Right? 9. Let's count again. 9. Yeah, 9. 11. Damn. One shot little. Also, if I had one more mana, that would have been little. So I guess I'm just gonna silence this. I must safeguard the land. I also send my face into it and trade this and do 2 more damage. No, I cannot attack. I cannot attack. Is there any reason I should the Ancient Watcher here? Probably not. If I do not attack, then he will probably Hellfire this Go down to 13, be able to play. Yeah. If I attack, you'll just play Molten Giants for free, so I'm not gonna attack. Also, there's no reason to Mark of the Wild anything, since this will die to Hellfire anyway. This won't die to Hellfire, and this will just respawn. So I think not attacking is a good play, because Hellfire and the attack from my Harvest Golem will put him down to 10, which means 3 Molten Giants. Now he'll be able to play only one Molten Giant. Right? Because Molten Giants, it's 2 mana. So it was really a good choice not to attack right there. Oh man! D-Ragdo. So I'm gonna rag and Mark of the Wild. In the best case I win, in the worst case I kill this, which is great. So I won. But the Mark of the Wild prevents me from... Well, in this case, prevents me from dying to something like Leroy Faceless, Power of Overwhelming Faceless, and just soak an attack from the giant. Basically, I mitigate 8 damage with that Harvest Golem taunted. And in this special case, it also means that I either kill him because he had 8 life, or I just kill a giant, which is awesome. So we're doing pretty good. I think I've lost only one game, and I don't even know how many I won. Like 3? I think 3. Mage, okay. This is probably Freeze Mage, it's really popular nowadays. So I'm just gonna keep the Sun Fury Protector to kill the mirror images really fast. If it's anything else, then... if it's like a standard mage, then it might be... Oh, wow. Mana Orb, that's really interesting. Well, like, it's pretty common, I guess. Should I innervate Mark of the Wild, though? Not really. Actually... Yeah, I think I should. Should I? Wait. So, if I'm gonna Sun Fury this, if I'm only gonna Sun Fury, then I will have to Hero Power next turn to kill this. Most likely. So I will not be able to innervate the Druid of the Claw. So I might as well just do this. Because you'll have like no way to remove this until turn 4, and he will still do his job by killing the Mana Worm and doing some damage to the face, basically. At worst, he will do something like fireball my face, do nothing, and just... Wow. Oh wow. That's really interesting and awkward at the same time. I'm just gonna kill that just because of Frostbolt Coin. Frostbolt Coin ping kills this and leaves the Mana Worm alive. Like this, he will not. He will like just Frostbolt. Oh wow. Oh wow. Oh wow. I think I should trade here. Even though I won't be able to play anything. I mean, this will die to the Hero Power. I don't have a good play to do this turn anyway, so my play is on turn 5, so if I can waste his turn 4 to do something like this and not play anything or play it to drop, then it's fine. Because I can Druid of the Claw. Now, Druid of the Claw in Bear form basically dies to Fireball, but Druid of the Claw in Cat form dies to basically Frostbolt. So it's like, what do you want to play around, the Frostbolt or the Fireball? I think in this case I'm just gonna go for Bear Form. Just because if he's gonna Fireball this, then he will have a harder time to remove the Ancient of Lore. And if he wants to poly the Ancient of Lore, then he will have no answer to Karn or to Rag. So this is probably Fireball, most likely. Yeah. No surprise. I don't think there's a high priority silence target in his deck, so I'm just gonna go and kill the Manor. Gives me a guy on board, not a huge guy on board, but yeah, something to play with. I was just about to say that we should see a Water Elemental around pretty fast. I'm just gonna go Ancient of Lore here, even if he flames like this, it's not that bad. I'm also gonna attack into the... I'm gonna attack into the Sunfury Protector just to play around Flamestrike. If he Flamestrikes this, then I can go and swipe the Sunfury Protector and trade this into this. This will die if he chooses to Flamestrike this. Oh wow. Either way, having two swipes in my hand, it's really good. So he will trade this, right? Actually Frostbolt. Yeah, that's fine. That's fine either way. I'm gonna kill the Drake. Kill the Drake and Harvest Golem probably. Oh yeah, Rag, nice. This will soak one attack from the Water Elemental, and at the same time... Oh wow, he's going face. Oh, no, actually not. What is going on? Hey, speak to me. Now I'm a bit scared, to be honest, of dying, but he played one Fireball and one Frostbolt, so even if he has like Burst in his hand, it's probably not that much. I could Mark of the Wise. This is a bit harder turn, to be honest. Drawing cards, I don't think it's an option right here. Playing the Ancient Watcher without on it may get a poly, which means a free reg. And just end turn. It's a bit bad because it uses my mana inefficiently, but this will get at least a Fireball and a ping. And my swipe will eventually get bigger. He's looking for an answer, probably a Polymorph. You should really watch where he's gonna play the... there's a Flamestrike. Not a huge Flamestrike, to be honest. It's not killing that much. That's fine. That's fine, I can Rag right now. I think he would prefer to poly that instead of going to... Flamestrike, because that was a pretty bad Flamestrike. Well, not bad Flamestrike, but... it might be just mind games and expecting a Ragnaros from me. But I'm gonna Rag anyway, because it's good if he kills this or just go face. YOLO Rag. I would have preferred to kill the Water Elemental, but I guess it's fine. Not really fine though. I have no time for games. Oh wow, Sylvanas. So glad I have a silence right now. Oh my god, the silence is gonna be so good. Oh my Jesus. Oh wow. So I'm gonna silence anyway, I guess.
I must safeguard the light.
Should I go Karn also? No, I shouldn't. If I killed, if I swipe this, there will be a higher chance to kill the Water Elemental of the Sylvanas. But I also might be dead, so I might as well just heal myself. He will have 4. In the worst case, he will hit this, so he will have 9 damage. And I'm gonna be dead to another fireball, right? But if I'm gonna heal myself, I will not be dead. And also, I have so heavy mana curve, so heavy cards that I don't really need the card draw at this moment. So I hope that he'll kill this or this. Yeah, that's good. That's really good. I didn't consider the second flame strike, which might be bad, but what can you do? Probably flame strike, right? No, frostball. Oh, that's awesome. That's really good for me. So no flame strike. Oh, and fireball. Oh, that's awesome. So that means no flame strike and no polymorph. So I can just go Karn and laugh. I'm not that scared of... I'm not that scared of dying, to be honest, at this point. Because he used most of the board clears on myself. Most of the burst on minions. Do I win? Please. Oh shit, no ice block. 4, 6... What do I need to win? I don't think I'm gonna win. No, I'm not gonna win, but I'm gonna clear the board pretty nice, to be honest.
For honor.
That swipe though. I'm gonna play this in town since no flame strike yet. No flame strike to be seen. Only if you like top decks the flame strike. Nope, no flame strike. That swipe though.
The eyes of the earth mother are upon.
Oh wow. That actually does nothing. Just delays, but it's fine. I definitely don't want to take 4 damage. Just because of a random pyroblast or I don't even know. Like another top deck fireball or something. Bullshit like that. The only question is, do I attack with the keeper or with the harvest golem? Probably the harvest golem. He would have killed the harvest golem anyway next turn. This turn, so like this, I keep 2-2, right? Yeah, a 2-2 instead of a 2-1. Arcane missiles, wow, interesting. No reason why to not watch her threat here, to be honest. I'm probably not gonna die to anything because I have 11 health, so pyroblast. It's not gonna kill me. I'm actually gonna change the deck a bit. It also seems that most of the time I'm playing from the top deck, which I don't like. And also the Ancient Watchers... it's been pretty bad with Ancient Watchers, so I'm gonna get a bit heavier curve and play double Azure Drake. I'm gonna keep the Picky Hunter, I really think it's really good. Also keep the wild mark of the wild. I'm not really sure of something the protectors right now, to be honest. I might wanna get something, something maybe like Argus. Or what can I play? I have no faces, right? Because I have this enchanted head, but Dread of the Claw for some nature. Probably an Argus is fine. Not an Arthos, an Argus. And Earthling. Or a Pyromancer. Pyromancer would be interesting. I'm just gonna go with the Farseer. Actually, I might just go double Farseer. Oh shit, Keeper. Yeah, and go another Farseer. It's really good. I have like high health creatures, such as Druid of the Claw and Yetis and such, and you can get a lot of value in control versus control with the Farseer, rather than having another Sanfiri Protector or something like that. Also, at the same time, it's really good versus Miracle to heal yourself and versus the Priest Mage to heal yourself after the Electreza. Oh wow, Inner Raid. So I'm gonna be able to play Yeti on first turn, which is insane. Should I keep Keeper? I think I might keep Keeper. No, not really. I need the card draw or refs or something like that. The Farseer is really good. I can kill with Yeti something like Unbound Elemental and still be fine. Oh wow, an Argion Squire. Interesting, to say the least. I'm gonna go Yeti anyway, I don't care that much. Now, this will not die this turn. It will die only to Rock Beater, this and Lightning Bolt, but that's unlikely, to be honest. I'm gonna kill the totem just because I wanna keep my AT as safe as possible from playing Fang or something like that. And I'm also gonna break the bubble on this. I will be able to heal the Yeti this turn with the Farseer, so if this Yeti is not gonna die and he will play like an Unbound, I'm in such a good spot. The light protects me. Please attack into Yeti. Oh no, he didn't. That's too bad, I guess. I think I'm gonna kill the totem just because I don't mind if he gets another 1-1, right? I'm not gonna heal the 80 just for one health because it's not gonna make a huge difference. Actually, it might because this will die to Lightning Bolt, so I think that was a misplay. No! Turns out to be better not to heal him. So I'm really glad I kept the Hurtling Farseer. Really glad I keep it. I keep the Farseer. So that's what I said when I swapped the Farseer with the... the Ancient Watchers. The Ancient Watchers are really good in versus aggro, but it just seems there's a lot of control on the ladder right now, a lot of shaman. So I think I'm just gonna adapt to that and play the right way. Now he has a Doomhammer on, which means next turn he will have 4 mana. 4 mana usually means not much. Probably an Unbound or a Harvest Golem and another spell. Something like Rockbiter his weapon. So with Rockbiter, he'll be able to kill the Yeti anyway, and the Azure Drake. Wait. Is there any reason to Druid of the Claw? Actually, yes. Like drew the claw in taunt mode and kill the Argent Squire, right? Let's do that. Just because of Rockbiter. I have a feeling he had the Rockbiter all this time in his hand, but he just keep it to play with Doomhammer. Silence, okay. So no Rockbiter. Oh wow. Oh wow. That's fine. I'm just gonna go Drake because there's no reason to heal this. Oh. Forgot about that. That top deck was pretty good. I think Doomhammer is like such an underrated weapon. I think it's really good since like Harrison it's not that popular nowadays. You only see it in like warrior matchup or something like that. So yeah, by doing this I saved the Druid of the Claw, which I think it's okay to be honest. I'll try to clear the board as much as possible just because I have a rag to hit his face and he's low already. If he will go something like kill this any creature, if he chooses to kill any creature with his face, then he'll go down to 8 HP and there's a chance that he will die to rag, which is good. And he will do that. No, he didn't. That's a good play from him actually. So I'm not gonna rag this turn, I'm just gonna Azure Drake. Hope for a ref. I got the ref, that's insane. I'm gonna ref for 2. Should I ref for 2? Yeah, I ref for 2. And I'm not gonna attack. I'm just gonna keep my creatures healthy. That's fine also. Come on, Rag. The Rag, do your job, man. There's a slight chance that I will die to something ridiculous like... I don't even know. Oh, wait. Ah, there's no need to Rag. Since I can win this game or just kill a creature, it's fine. No, that's great. That's like the best. Yeah, that's fine. To be expected. Oh wow. The ref value though. Ooh, swipe. Let me see if I can top deck another swipe right here, so I can win the game. Oh, not really, but not far. I think I'm gonna ref the... I'm gonna ref this to be honest, right? This is a bit risky because I all died to Leroy Windfury. But yeah. Basically I'm dead to Leroy Windfury, but Leroy is not that common. He also has 3 cards in his hand, so I'm not that worried. I just wanna keep the swipe because there's a chance that I'm gonna get the other swipe. Or just kill it with the Savage Roar if I have a creature on board or something like that. Actually, yeah. If he's not able to kill this, I just win. And he's not gonna kill it. Well played. but I really have to appreciate what he did there. I don't think that, I don't know if he did it on purpose, not attacking my creatures to go to eat HP so he will die to rag. I think he just not attacked because he had the lightning storm in his hand, but either way it was a...